What's up, everyone? My name is Raleigh, and I actually want to start this video off by asking you a simple question, and that's, what do you want to do for the rest of your life? What are your career goals and aspirations? Now, if you're one of those fortunate people who know exactly what you want to do, you already have this planned out and figured out, and you're on a path to get there, heck yeah, kudos to you. Like, you're awesome. You're way ahead of the game, and that's great. But I think for the vast majority of us, I think we're still trying to figure it out. Right? Like, if this question came up on the exam of life or whatever, I think a lot of us would look at that question, get a little scared, put our names at the top of the paper, turn it in, and walk out. I think we just get out of there as fast as possible because that question's hard to answer for a lot of us, right? And this is shown by articles published in Forbes, for example, where they say 50% of millennials plan on quitting their job within the next 2 years. And of those, a lot of people who were asked that same question recently quit their last job. So they're kind of job hopping, right? And a lot of people aren't hopping from like one job to the next, right? They're not going from like accountant to senior accountant. A lot of those people are shifting entirely, right? Like, I know someone who used to be studying diseases and medicine. Would have been great if he stayed in that industry given what's going on, but now he's writing code and building software applications. So he like made a big shift, right? And that's pretty common, right? People aren't staying in the same industry or the same path and just continuing on with it. And that's really what I want to dig into today because I think, like, if you ask your parents, right, a lot of them like act like, oh, I knew exactly what I was doing at 19. I knew I was going to be a teacher. That's what I was going to do. And that's what I did, right? Like, they paint this picture like they knew everything, right? And I think for a lot of us, again, we're still trying to figure it out. And we make up a lot of the workforce, in fact, the majority of it nowadays. So we should, you know, start to get some context clues and be figuring it out at this point, at least one would think. So that's what I plan on digging into in my video. I want to discuss the three main reasons why I think we as a generation are still trying to figure out what we want to do. Now, before I jump into that, I just want to say, if you think I'm totally wrong on my analysis here, like, tell me in the comments, let me know. Hey, Raleigh, I think you're a little off your rocker. Or if you agree with me, that'd be great too. Let me know, like, oh yeah, that makes total sense. That's really what this channel is about, is sparking discussion, having some conversations, and really learning from one another. So drop a comment in the comment section below. If you like this video, of course you should like it. And of course you should subscribe, because crap, I mean, you liked the video, right? So anyway, let's jump into the three reasons why I think we as millennials are still trying to figure out what we want to do in life. So I think the first reason why we're a little lost or still trying to figure out what we want to do in terms of our career path has to do with the internet and how it's impacted us. So, I mean, if you think about it, right, if you go and you look at jobs in your local area on like LinkedIn Jobs or something, you'll see a huge wide range of jobs, everything from like a fisherman, if you're near the ocean, of course, or like an iron worker or someone in finance or marketing or a doctor or an engineer, right? Like, the list goes on and on. It's endless, truly. And in addition to that, you see the requirements for those jobs, and you also oftentimes see how much those jobs pay. So you're getting a snapshot of each one of these jobs, and you're able to compare that to like what your current situation is like, right? So ultimately, you're able to see everything out there that exists in terms of opportunities for your career growth or development, or even just, you know, trying something new. Then you couple that with the fact that we as a generation have kind of, or, you know, as people in general, I think a lot of people have experienced this, but you've heard, if you work really hard, you can have whatever you want. If you work hard to be an engineer and you really study, right, like, you could become an engineer. Or if you want to start your own business, like, you can go do it. You just got to be a go-getter, right? So we've kind of grew up with that sense, especially here in the United States, of, hey, whatever you put your mind to, you can do. And this creates like a situation where we have a feeling of like missing out, right? Or FOMO. And it's kind of like someone who goes into a buffet, right? And they don't know where to start. They don't know if they should eat a salad first, or they don't know if they should start with dessert because, you know, they might be too full to where they can't eat dessert. Or if they start with dessert, then they never eat a salad, and then they feel bad because they didn't eat healthy before they ate dessert, right? They were too full to have that salad at the end. So this kind of plays out in our career, in our life, right? Like, we're worried that because we're doing accounting right now, we should probably be doctors. They make more money. Or, hey, we're doctors. We have a ton of debt. We should have just went into marketing. Like, that seems fun, right? Like, maybe I make less money, but I could start working right away. And it seems maybe more interesting, or it seems like less stressful if I'm a doctor who's doing like crazy things, right? So we all kind of have this feeling of missing out. And I think the internet and the access that we have to everything that exists out there has created that sense of like, we're missing out on something, regardless of what we're doing today. Now, the second reason why I think us as a generation are still trying to figure out what we want to do has to do with us just trying to make it through the month and trying to survive, right? Like, we don't really have the opportunity to sit down and really think about what we want to do. And just to explain this really quickly, I'm going to go through some figures here real fast. So the cost of college tuition has gone up 216% over the past 20 years. So what that means is someone graduating in 2020 with a bachelor's degree has about $37,500 worth of student loan debt, and that's before they even have a job or a means to pay it off, right? And then continuing along with that, we've dealt with two pretty big economic situations, right? One being the housing market crash about 10 years ago, right? A lot of people lost their jobs, a lot of people were struggling, and now we're dealing with this coronavirus situation where, again, a lot of people lost their jobs and a lot of people are struggling. And what that means is during the early portions of millennials' career, right? We're trying to establish and grow and kind of move up the corporate ladder, going from like an entry-level job to an associate to a manager to a director. And during that time, a lot of people have been stagnated, right? There hasn't been a lot of promotions or growth or anything like that. And so really, we're just kind of jumping around from job to job. And what that has led to is a situation where, according to the Pew Research Center, real wages for the middle class nowadays is the same as it was 40 years ago. So things are getting more expensive, and our wages aren't necessarily keeping up with that. We make the same amount of money as someone did 40 years ago. 40 years ago, not four, 40. And so, like, again, what all this creates is a situation where we're just trying to survive, right? Like, we're just trying to make it. We're not like able to sit down and, you know, really plan out or take on additional debt to go to school and get that next degree or take on that next certification or whatever it might be. We're really just taking whatever job will pay the bills this month and kind of going from there, right? So again, we just don't have time to like sit down or the opportunity or the money to sit down and plan out what we want to do moving forward because we're just so worried about today. Now, the third reason why I think we're still trying to figure out what we want to do or are a little unsure about ourselves has to do with social media and its impact on us. I mean, if you think about it, right? Previously, it was a situation where it was keeping up with the Joneses or the people in your circle, right? And now it's a situation where it's basically keeping up with the Kardashians, right? I mean, every time you go on social media and you look at someone's story or a post, you're subconsciously comparing yourselves to them, right? So every time I see, for example, that Drake is rocking $1,000 pair of pants and flying off to Rome and doing crazy stuff, I'm subconsciously thinking, like, what did I do wrong? How come I'm here at Sprouts trying to find a discount on this chicken? And yet, you know, he can go fly around and have awesome meals in Rome whenever he wants willy-nilly. And so again, I think social media and its impact on us has created a situation where we're constantly feeling like we're missing out and we're second guessing our choices in life rather than sticking with a particular path which we chose in the first place, right? We're thinking, man, this is my situation and that's his situation, so maybe I should try doing that instead. And so it creates a situation where we're jumping from one thing to the next and just really have this feeling of missing out, like we should be doing something else rather than what we're doing today. Now, it's not all doom and gloom. I want to like take a step back and really quickly just address this a little bit and like share some things that helped me in dealing with these questions and this situation a little bit in hopes that it'll help you as well. So the first thing you can do is take some time to sit down and really think about what you currently do and be honest with yourself, right? Like ask yourself those tough questions. And this is hard, but it's important. So ask yourself, like, am I happy with what I do today? Do I want to do something different? When I look at my boss, does my boss seem happy? Do I see myself doing what my boss does? You know, am I currently fulfilled in my role, or is there something I should be doing that's completely different that I will enjoy more? And ask these tough questions and be honest with yourself. And once you have the answers to those questions, and again, it's really hard to do this, but once you have the answers to those questions, act on it and go for it, right? Like, be honest with yourself, figure out who you are, and act upon it. Now, full disclaimer here, you might be a little surprised at these answers, and they might lead you to make some crazy drastic situations. For example, I had a friend when we had this conversation who went from working at the Federal Reserve as like a bank analyst, and now he's applying to be in the Air Force to be like a jet pilot. So, you know, very drastic changes. So you might be surprised with the results. But at the end of the day, I'll be honest, he's much happier now than he was. And he does seem like he's having a much more fulfilled life, even though that's a very drastic change. He definitely seems like he's much more happy. Now, the second thing you need to do is stop comparing yourself to others. And the reason why this is important is because when you do so, you're always comparing yourself to the perfect version of someone else, right? No one posts on social media their challenges or the issues they're having. And if they do, you know, that's the exception. But oftentimes, they're painting themselves in like this perfect image or this perfect light. Whereas, you know, you in reality don't see the challenges that they faced or the struggles that they had to get to that point in their lives or that they're currently dealing with. You only see the fact that they're flying to Rome to enjoy a meal. You don't see them sitting on the couch eating a tub of ice cream because they had a really bad week or whatever it might be, right? So it's unfair to compare yourself to others because you're comparing your real self to the perfect version of someone else. And this extends to like older people too, right? Like to your parents, for example. If you're trying to compare yourself to your parents and you're like, man, my parents, when they were my age, they had a home all paid off. They had two cars. They had two kids. Like, they seemed to be doing pretty well and having it together. Again, they had challenges and struggles too that you weren't aware of. And also, the economy was set up totally different back then, if you think about it, right? Like, the wages were different. Things cost way less than they do today. So it's really hard, and actually, it's impossible to compare yourself apples to apples with someone from a different, like, age group, but also someone who's totally different. So you can never compare apples to apples. So simply stop doing it. It's way healthier for yourself and way healthier for everyone out there. Now, the third thing you can do is focus on yourself and building your personal equity each and every week. And so what I mean by that is building your skills, right? Go take that creative writing or video editing class, learn a new language, take a certification class if it's, affordable and makes sense to help you along with your career. Go ahead and invest in yourself. And what this will do is expand your critical thinking skills. It'll expand your skill set in general and ultimately open new doors for yourself and create an opportunity for you to be the best version of yourself, which is really the only thing you can compare yourself or compare to, right? You can only compare to yourself to give you like a true apples to apples situation. I can only compare my Spanish speaking skills today compared to how they were last year, for example. I can't compare my Spanish speaking skills and how much they've improved compared to like my friend Danny or whatever it might be. So again, just continue to build your own personal equity, focus on yourself and being the best version of yourself. That'll open new doors and opportunities and really just create a more healthy situation where you're not comparing yourself to others, rather to yourself, and you'll be able to see improvement upon yourself rather than just like, man, I'm falling behind what's or like so and so or whatever it might be. So third one, focus on yourself, build your own personal equity. So really quickly, just to summarize, three reasons why I think us as generation are still trying to figure out exactly what we want to do has to do with one, the internet and its impact on us in terms of creating this situation where we feel like we're missing out on something, right? Two, it has to do with the economy in general and the economic situations that occurred, creating situations where we're a little stagnant in terms of our opportunity and growth. And last but not least, the creation of social media where we're consistently comparing ourselves subconsciously to others in an unrealistic manner, right? And that again creates this situation or feeling of missing out, like we should be doing something else. Now, to combat this, again, I'm just summarizing this real quickly for you all. You should take the time to ask yourself what you want to do and really focus on that and act on that specifically. And then again, try not to compare yourself to others. Limit your time on social media and do your best to compare, not compare yourself to others, because that's really doing a disservice to yourself because you can never truly compare yourself to others. They have a totally different situation going on. They always paint themselves in the best light, right? And you don't see kind of the struggles or demons that they're dealing with. And the third thing you can do is focus on growing your own personal equity and focus on making yourself the best version of you. And this is truly a situation where it allows you to compare yourself today to where you were a month ago or a year ago. And that really gives you a baseline to build off of. And it opens more doors and opportunities as you build your skill sets and critical thinking skills to really open new doors and take advantage of new opportunities that, might follow along the lines of what you found out in the first thing that I recommended, which is once you answer those questions about what you want to do, build the skill sets to really take advantage and kind of just pounce on that, right? So that's it, folks. Those are my thoughts in terms of why I think us as a generation are still trying to figure out what exactly we want to do. Let me know in the comment section if you think I'm off my rocker and you totally disagree, or if you agree with my thoughts and want to discuss further. Again, let me know in the comment section below. That's really what this channel is all about, is to create quality discussions about interesting topics and hopefully create opportunities where we have the chance to learn from one another. So again, let me know your thoughts in the section, in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear from you. So with that said, if you like this video, please support the channel and like it. If you really love this video, of course, don't forget to subscribe. I plan to put out more videos as the weeks go on. So keep up with me, not the Kardashians, and I'll be hearing from you guys later. Take it easy.